This is Dr. Holt. This is one of the WebAssign problems. You have a uniform ring here of 1.4 meters in diameter is pivoted at one point on its perimeter so that it is free to rotate about a horizontal axis initially. The line joins the support point and the center is horizontal. So what I have here, I've moved it into the position. I have a ring. It's mounted so it can rotate about this point here. And basically, we're going to hold it and then let it go. All right, so to work this problem, we know when it's at the lower point, I'll kind of see if I can clone this, it's going to move down here at a lower point. And let's see if I can clone that too. Move that up back into position. So basically, that would be position two, and I'll make this lighter. Okay, so this is where it's going to start. It's going to rotate down to here. So what I want to do is I'm going to set this as my, basically my axes here. I want to take everything off of this. So relative to the lower point, we're going to use the conservation of mechanical energy, and we're going to say the potential energy initial plus kinetic energy initial must equal to potential energy final plus kinetic energy final. Okay, so we're going to let this thing go from rest. When we let it go from rest, then the velocity when it first goes here is going to be zero. So it's going to have just nothing but potential energy. We will take the mass of this, which we'll call mass m. We'll multiply that by g and then r, r being the radius of this. All right, so now this would be plus zero because it has no velocity. When it gets down to the bottom, it's going to lose all its potential energy, and now it's going to have kinetic energy. Now the kinetic energy, you want to just do 1/2 times the moment of inertia times omega squared. All right, scroll down, give myself a little bit more space. Let's grab this and move it down, and we're going to go ahead and solve the rest of the problem. All right, now what you have to be careful with is with an inertia, you are rotating about this point here. So we want to do the moment of inertia of a uniform ring. I'm going to come over here, inertia of uniform ring. And that value is m times r squared. Okay, we'll take this, put it back in the equation. We will have m times g times r is equal to 1/2 times my mass times my radius squared. Now, this inertia here is only about the center of the mass. We must still do the mass times r squared. We're doing the parallel axis theorem. Times omega squared. All right, while we're here, we might as well just cancel out our masses. So we'll cancel out this mass here, and this mass here. All right, let's go ahead and simplify and see what we have. We have g times r. We'll have 1/2 plus 2r squared. Not 1/2 plus, I'm sorry, let me change that real quick. 1/2 times. 1/2 times 2r squared omega squared. My 2's will cancel out here. And here. So now we will put everything, we're going to solve for omega. So we'll have g times r, we'll divide by r squared. R will cancel out here, here. So what we will have, and again, that's all going to equal to omega. We take the square of that. So omega is going to equal to the square root of g over r. So now we can put the values in. We can know that's 9.8. We go back, we look and see what the radius was, and the radius was a 1.4 diameter, so we will put 0.7 in for that. and that will be our value. Run that through the calculator real quick. We have 9.8 divided by 0.7. Second square root, second answer. Gives me a value of 3.71. Excuse me, 3.742, basically, radians per second. All right, that's how you're going to do part A. Excuse me, part A. All right, now part B, I think we'll get the right answer there. Part B says, what's the minimum initial angular velocity must be given is to rotate a full 360? All right, so let's grab this. And copy that. We'll bring that down to here. Okay. And bring this back into place. Now, for it to go a full 360, what's going to take place? This is going to rotate all the way around, have to go all the way back up to the top. And then move that up to the top to give me some room. So that's what's going to do to get to the very top. So I kind of move that in place, kind of like that. All right. So if it goes all the way back to the top, then it's going to have enough momentum to continue back over to do the full 360. So now we'll do this problem very similar. Now this distance here, now it's gone 1r. This distance would be 2r. Right, and then this distance here is going to be just the R. So we go back and we do the conservation mechanical energy again. The initial, when it first starts horizontally, will be mass times G times R, okay, plus the required momentum, excuse me, plus the required angular velocity. So we need to do 1/2 times I times omega squared initial, because I need that initially to get all the way back up here, and then just set that equal to 2 times m times g times r, where the 2 is the 2r. That's mass times gravity times height, and I put the 2 back in front. So that's going to be our equation. So we just put our values, we got mgr plus 1/2. Again, we know what the I is. I is just mr squared plus mr squared, so we can say plus 2 on 2 mr squared. Times our omega squared. That must equal to 2 mgr. Alright, again, so we can start canceling things out. We got a mass here, cancel this out, cancel mass here. We can also cancel an R here, this one, and this one's gone also. So let's see what we end up with. We have G plus R omega is equal to 2G. Alright, so now we want to move the G to the other side. Okay, that leaves us G plus R times omega squared is equal to 2G. We subtract G from both sides, that leaves us R omega squared is equal to G. We divide by R omega squared is equal to G over R. Omega is going to equal to the square root of G over R. Again, that looks like it's going to give us the same value we had before. Omega is equal to the square root of 9.8, and our radius is 0.7. We do that, and that gives us a value of the square root of 14, so second square root 14 gives us 3.74. Radius per second, and we go back up, check our answer, and we got the same. So that's how you work that problem. So if the problem, as far as going back up, if you gave it that much initial angular velocity, this ring would come all the way back up to the vertical point. So that's how you work that problem.